Hey everybody, this is Bill Heenan from the Bill Heenan Real Estate Show. And if you're a buyer buying a house in our market right now, you're going to want to stick around for this episode. Good morning, everybody. Welcome back to the fourth episode of the Bill Heenan Real Estate Show. I'm excited about the topic we have here today. As you can see from the board behind me, I wanted to focus a little bit on mortgage contingencies and the purchase and sale contract that relate to protecting the buyers. There are three major contingencies in our purchase and sale agreement that protect the buyer. One is the inspection contingency, two is the mortgage appraisal contingency, and three is the mortgage approval contingency itself. The first one that takes place is the inspection contingency. And after a buyer has a purchase and sale contract that's agreed to between them and the seller, and it's been signed and delivered back to the buyer, then at that point we go into our inspection contingency period. Generally that's about 2 weeks. And a buyer will hire an inspection agency to inspect all the major components of a house, the roof, the plumbing, the electrical system, the septic, the well, if you have either one of those two. But we check everything out, radon in the water. We check everything out. And if for any reason the buyer is not happy with the results of those inspection contingencies or those inspection results, then they have the right to petition the seller to either repair the things they're not happy with or ask for a release of the contract and request that their deposit monies would be returned. And at that point, they would get their deposit monies back. The second contingency is the mortgage appraisal. When you have an agreement with a seller and everything's signed at that price, then the house has to appraise for that, you know, through the appraisal, through the bank appraisal for that price. If for some reason the house does not appraise for the price that you've agreed to with the seller, then you would request the seller to do either adjust the price to reflect that mortgage appraisal amount, or you can opt out of the contract if you can't come to an agreement at that point, and the seller would be obligated to return your deposit monies as well. And then the third contingency is the mortgage approval process itself. Most buyers have pre-qual letters or pre-approval letters that they'll use in their process of buying the house. And 99% of the time, especially if you're dealing with one of our loan specialists, those pre-approval or pre-qual letters are good and you shouldn't have any issues, but it's not the formal mortgage approval process. And when they do the mortgage approval process, they're gonna check a little bit more thoroughly your credit, your income, and your ability to pay. But if for any reason you were denied the mortgage, then once again, you would request that the seller return your deposit monies based on the mortgage approval denial. And once again, the seller would be obligated to return your deposit monies back to you. So I hope you didn't mind my phone ringing in the middle of the video there. But as always, if you like some of the information that you're hearing from our shows, please click the subscribe button on the bottom right-hand corner. And you can always visit us at our website, www.billheenan.net. Reach out to us. We're always looking forward to hearing from you, and have a great day.